during this video, we will walk through the setup process for live chat. First, configure a few user accounts to take live chats. Go to Users in Dynamics Security Setting and add the Omnichannel agent role to a few accounts. This gives the accounts access to Omnichannel dashboards and records. Set up chat queues. Go to the Omnichannel Administration application, select Queues from the sitemap, and create a couple support queues. For this demonstration, the business will take product questions and billing questions. A queue will be set up for each type of question. Then add some user accounts to the product queue. Do the same for the billing queue. Now, set up a workstream and chat widget to take in live chat requests from a customer-facing portal. First, go to Workstreams in the Omnichannel Administration application. Create a new workstream. Name it something that makes sense. In this demonstration, it is called Chat Workstream. We are setting up live chat, so the channel is live chat. Now, configure the work distribution settings. With these settings, each chat will take up 30 capacity units when assigned to an agent. It will be pushed to an agent via a notification, and the agent will be able to accept the incoming request or let it time out after 60 seconds. Agents can receive these chats when they have available capacity and their presence is set to either available or busy. Next, set up the customer-facing chat widget. On the sitemap, go to Chat. Create a new chat widget. Name it something that makes sense. For this demonstration, it is called Chat Widget. In this demonstration, we want to show the agent's full name when the conversation is happening, so display name is set to full name. In the work distribution settings, select the workstream this widget to submit to. Now, save the widget and copy down the chat widget snippet code for later reference. Now, make some modifications to the chat widget design. In this demonstration, the logo is modified. Everything else looks good here. Then, add a pre-chat survey to collect some information from the customers. This information can be used to route the chats properly. Here, the chat widget will ask the customer one question. Are you having a billing or a product support issue? This question will be used to set up routing rules. There is one more thing to complete. Setting up the routing rules to make sure the chats are routed based on the response to the survey. Go back to the workstream to set up the routing rules. Click on Routing Rules. Two rules are set up here. One to map chats that selected billing to the billing queue, and one to map chats that selected product support to the product queue. Now that everything is set up, go ahead and add the chat widget code to a portal. The script can be added to any portal. In this example, it is added to the Dynamics 365 portal. Go to the Dynamics 365 Portals app and select Content Snippets. Find the chat widget code snippet. Paste the widget code from earlier into the HTML field and hit Save. And there we have it. The chat widget is set up on our portal and will route to a product or billing support queue based on the option the customer selects.